Julian Fellowes investigates a most mysterious murder in half an hour here on BBC One.
Welcome to the last A Question of Sport of 2005, and we're ending the year in style with a fantastic guest lineup. But sadly, it's not out with the old and in with the new, because they're still here. The captains, Matt and Ali. And on Matt's team tonight, two men with the same initials and a similar sporting pedigree.
Some of the shots that he's played in the last 20 minutes or so confirm that he really is a player of high class.
Excellent shot. Get in, they cry. And they were right.
Another chance here. Got hold of that, all right. Screamer. Back to Redknapp. What a magnificent goal. Jamie Redknapp.
Please welcome Justin Rose and Jamie Redknapp. American flavour as he's joined by two former world number ones, one from athletics, the other from tennis.
Well, he's done it with an ace, by a wonderful performance by Team Courier.
Again, the Masters tennis champion, Team Courier.
Rose is first at the moment, Phillips in second place, Lee in second. 47-01, and that's a new world record. Danny Harris closing up, but Ed Moses is going for the line. He's going to make it by 4 yards. And look at the time, 47-76. It's just outside his Olympic record.
Please welcome Jim Courier and the great Edwin Moses. On the picture board this week are 12 flags representing different countries of the world. If you need help, I'll give it to you. You're each to choose a flag, and the picture will be of a sports star from that country. Some are easier than others. And Jamie, we're going to start with you. Pick a flag.
Did she say that? She said that.
Yeah.
And Jamie.
So was it that obvious?
That's embarrassing.
Sorry.
That
I've been practicing.
Hold yourself together.
Rule number one, Sue, no salivating on the show. You know the drill. Come on, then.
Too late.
Thanks, Sue. I will have Brazil, please, Sue.
Oh, oh no!
That's disgusting.
Oh, that is. Well. Yeah, that's Kaká. Kaká.
It is the Brazilian midfielder. Well done. Edwin, here
we go. Sweden.
I mean, if we get a girl, let's go for Sweden.
Sweden.
Just for the picture.
Yeah. I'll take Sweden.
Sadly not.
Wow. Yeah, it's got to be Bjorn.
Bjorn.
Has to be.
It is.
With a paddle, though?
He was rowing over for the Wimbledon that year,
remember? Right. Yeah. Yeah, that's Bjorn.
It is, yeah. Bjorn Borg, five-time Wimbledon champion. And Justin, you'll go?
South Africa.
Oh.
Oh, well, oh,
very nice.
Yeah,
right,
I think it's the goose, isn't it? Retief Goosen.
It is. Two-time US Open winner. Well done. Jim.
We'll go to the US. We're going to really fly on a limb here. Oh, yeah. Speaking of flying.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Larry Bird.
Yes. Yeah, Boston Celtics legend. Well done. Going so well so far. Will it continue, captains? Matt first.
What's the one in the bottom right-hand corner, just out of interest?
Bottom right is Mozambique.
You were right. Yeah. You were right.
In fact, have a point for it. Well played.
I think we'll probably go for Argentina, please.
Yes, baby. Yes.
Backfire.
Feel the pain.
That's possibly not what we wanted.
Maradona there, weren't we?
We were hoping
Maradona.
For the hand of God. Argentinian tennis player. What about
you
him?
Very recent sort of pictures.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. We'll go with Mr. Nalbandian.
Holy cow, he pronounced it right.
He did indeed.
Yes!
2002 Wimbledon finalist. Ali, over to you.
What's left?
Which one? I'll say Netherlands, Ireland, Spain, Russia, Australia, France, and Mozambique.
Russia.
Russia.
Beauty. Female tennis.
Yeah. Yeah, I think so. Yeah. That's Maria.
Tennis.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Sharapova.
No.
Yeah. Who?
How
about that? How about that?
Never heard of
you can't even pronounce that.
Yeah,
you?
No.
How about?
What does she do?
Miss.
Yeah, oh, here we go.
Isabayeva.
I think Edwin knew that soon after that. Yes, you're right. That's Yelena Isinbayeva. The Olympic gold medal winning
pole. Sue? Is that a bad thing for us?
Yeah.
It does. Yeah, I'm afraid it hurts you because at the
Come
end
on,
of the round.
I'm in agony.
Come on.
Ali's team are on four, Matt's team in front on eight. So, Matt, for sports action this week, you must bid on how many answers you think you'll get right. Yeah. If you match your bid, you will get a point per answer, but if you fail to match your bid, you will get nothing. And I can only accept your first answers. Right. Your team will see eight English sportsmen and women. How many are you going to gamble on?
Well, we've got a bit of a lead, so we don't have to do anything too aggressive.
Like it. Like course management. Like that. Great course management. Awesome.
Five was the number that came in my head.
Five? Happy with five?
Bogey. Level of bogey.
We'll go for bogey. We'll have five.
Play level five,
five, yeah. Level
You're
five.
You're going to go for five? Yeah. Okay. Here we go with your eight.
Putted so well earlier in the year in his first European Tour win. Oh, this is incredible, John.
Got so that slower ball and just waited for it. That was a gorgeous shot.
Well.
He must be very pleased as he comes in now and finishes first. What an outstanding victory.
So five of the eight you need. Confident?
Yeah, it'll be all right.
We're feeling good.
Where are you going to start?
That one's all right. Wade Dooley.
Yes, scoring a try against Wales.
Steve Webster.
Yep. Golfer. Winner of the 2005 Italian Open.
There you go, Ekiog.
Yep, scoring for Middlesbrough. Two more.
Bell.
First name.
The Ian Bell.
Is yeah, it is the Ashes winning cricketer.
Would you have that?
Yeah, one more.
Oh, that'll annoy me. You go with that then.
Yeah, Sharon Davis.
Yes, Olympic silver medal winning swimmer. Well done, you've got the five. Who are you annoyed about? Who can't you?
It was Cathy Cook.
It was Cathy Cook, yes.
Was it Mervyn King?
Darts. No, it was Ian McCulloch, the snooker player.
Oh, no, the darts.
It was Ted Hankey, the world Ted darts champion in 2000. But anyway, you've got your five. Well done, Ali. Eight American sports stars for you. How many do you think you and your team can name?
Go on!
Go for it! Eight Americans?
Come on,
American
you've got to go for it.
All American, yeah, are they?
Yeah, they're all American. But
how
some
much,
will
how
be
much TV
more
watching?
Difficult.
Come on, go for it. Come on, Ali, come on! Go for it, Ali! Come on, Ali!
You tell me when you're comfortable.
Come on!
Well, I'm a go at Six.
What did he say?
Six. We'll have a go at.
How many is that?
Six. Six or five. Six or five.
You tell me. I just like hearing you talk.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Don't worry, that's what I also love. Don't worry.
Okay.
I also.
What do you think, Edwin? Six or five?
We have to do something. I think we better go six.
Six it is, it?
Okay, well done. Six it is. Watch closely. Here we go.
For Johnson. Johnson, all.
And I think she's defended her title well. It's my cat. He's on. It's inches.
That was a great spin to finish.
A new world and Olympic record on the Wonder Slammer of 1972. Mm-hmm.
Stroll in the park, all right. Being that,
McCoy. Stroll in the park. We only need six, right?
Yeah.
All right, well, we're good. Barkley, Devers, we Dent, Kerrigan, Spitz. We're money.
Definitely with
Kerrigan. We're money.
Definitely.
We're there.
Yeah. It's happy with Kerrigan.
Don't screw this up.
Go on. I tell you what, I'm going to make you look good in British television. You can give the answers.
You want me to make?
Yeah.
I can't say it like you.
I think you can.
We're going to go with Charles Barkley.
Former Dream Team basketball player.
On the
yes.
dunk, yeah.
Well done.
That was.
Gail Devers.
Yeah, I want you to
Gail
contribute.
Devers.
That's
Gail Devers, American right. sprinter, and her.
Needed
yeah,
it, yeah. I needed him to contribute. Michelle Wee.
Yes, American golfer.
Why don't you throw that one in there? Can you say that name properly? Can you do it?
Right, marks out of 10 for the pronunciation.
Yes.
Taylor Dent.
Taylor Dent. I love it. I love it.
I can't believe it's a Yank giving my accent a stick here. What's going on?
Nancy Kerrigan.
Sorry, Jim didn't understand you.
Nancy Kerrigan.
Yes, Olympic silver medalist.
Mark Spitz. I don't know, how do you say that? Say that for me one time.
Mark Spitz.
Spitz.
Yeah, nine-time Olympic gold medalist.
Mark Spitz.
Those
and
are the six
noise.
You need. What? You got the footballer as well, didn't you?
McBride.
Yeah, Brian McBride, and scoring for Bar, Dan Lyle was the last one. But anyway, you got your six there, so end of the round. Ali's on 10, Matt in front on 13. So, Matt, an under-21 international between Cyprus and Wales for you. Wales have a free kick in the dying seconds of the game. The question is, what happened next?
What about the guy who's been pushed over? That one? I thought there was not a football match on this planet you've not watched.
There is a few. I don't remember watching Wales under-21s versus Cyprus. What do you reckon about E13? Just hit it first time and smashed it over the goalkeeper's head. The defender. Hooked it. You feeling it? He scoops out little 7-9.
What about the defender is going to clear, he's going to make a part, he's going to be the one that kicks the ball. Just fishing a little bit.
But is he lined up enough to kick it straight back this
yeah,
way? Why
so
is he going to kick it at the red? You know, back towards the guy in the red.
I mean, I do quite like your first idea, him turning around, looking, because
if well,
I thought he was talking to me just a minute ago.
You know what I mean? If the ball like runs away, he's gonna
back,
exactly. He's gonna like use his keeper, bartender. You go with that.
Yeah, I'll go with that.
He's looking for it to pass the ball back to the keeper, because it's the dying seconds to clear it. So knocks it back, big howl up, and it becomes an own goal.
You're talking about Agelos Efthimiou, the defender?
Nailed it.
Yeah?
Let's have a look. Under pressure, as you say.
Oh, lovely.
Back to the keeper. Oh. It all went wrong.
Oh.
last kick of the game, and Wales drew 3-3. Well done. Ali, an NFL game between the Green Bay Packers and the Cincinnati Bengals for you. Brett Favre is at the line of scrimmage, but what happened next? Beware, it's a quick one.
Is there any more information?
Yeah.
I think the clue is you needed to be there.
Did you say dying seconds or last seconds of the game at all?
Sadly not, no.
Doesn't give you any more
Brett
information?
Brett Favre, just at the line of scrimmage. Brett Favre, if that is a clue.
Now, you said you love your football, right?
I didn't see anything.
Wrong football.
Okay. All right, this is my suspicion is what he's done. What? Tell me what you think.
The center has the ball going upfield.
I think receivers have stopped, haven't they?
Well, you see the top receiver is sort of stopped, but there's no one on him. I can't see there's a defender.
If you didn't hear that well enough, I mean, the whistle had gone. Right?
Oh, okay. Well, clearly the whistle was not from the field. The whistle was from the stands, then, if that were the case. And I'm not giving you an answer. I'm talking.
Okay.
I'm looking at you, but I'm talking to my team.
Fine.
Not a bad decision to be
Yeah, field. Thank you.
I like the sound of that.
Yeah, me too. I think it's the whistle came from off the field. The players are sort of stopped. Favre is going to throw it to someone who's open. They're going to run down the field. I don't know if they're... Do we have to tell if they score or not? I mean, obviously they're going to...
Yeah, I mean, that would help.
That would help.
No, don't listen to him. There's definitely a whistle.
Run for long.
Not yardage. Come from the, not come
yeah,
from the field of play.
We don't have to...
And it's caused mayhem within the ranks of the field.
The fun mayhem.
And... Well, it's obvious, really.
But what, the question is, what happened next? The whistle's already gone.
Yeah.
Okay.
The
whistle's gone. No, he's not going to get sacked. He's going to stand there for a while, realize that the officials are still looking at him. Someone's going to go long. He's going to hit him, or someone's going to catch a pass, and they're going to advance the ball. But they're going to play. No one else realizes what's going on.
No, it isn't right. It goes on offer.
Was that our answer?
Yeah.
I was still.
Yeah. You'll see why I stopped you. No, it's not close.
So maybe.
How about
coming up?
We've just given them all this great information to work off of.
Yeah. Someone comes onto the field, like a supporter, a fan, something like that, and nicks the ball off Brett Favre.
Let's have a look. Turns around to see the reason for the whistle, and a fan does indeed steal the ball, races down the field. And that was a serious tackle. Did you know that, or did you just make that up?
Just a guess.
Very good, anyway. So. What a difference, end of the round. Ali's on 10, but Matt on 17. So now the guests have a choice of 1 point for a home question, 2 points if you go away from your sport. Jamie first, home question.
We'll go home, please.
What connects Vladimir Schmitz's last game for Liverpool to the last games of Kevin Keegan and Graham Souness for Liverpool and of Peter Schmeichel for Manchester United? What connects Vladimir Schmitz's last game for Liverpool to the last games of Keegan and Souness for Liverpool and Schmeichel for Manu?
Yep, I think that is a European Cup final. Win?
Yes,
that matter,
exactly. Yeah. Winning the European Cup final. Yeah. Well done, yes. Schmitz against AC Milan last season. Schmeichel in 99 against Bayern Munich. Souness against Roma in 84. And Keegan against Borussia Mönchengladbach in 77. So, Edwin, over to you. A home question or away?
I'll take a home question.
Who won Olympic gold at Barcelona in the men's 400 metres hurdles, having finished just outside the medals in Seoul?
Kevin Young.
Correct, yes. Well done. He broke the world record, which Edwin held for 9 years. Justin, your turn.
Home game, please.
Who was the only first-time winner of a major in 2005?
First-time winner of a major. Yep, Michael Campbell.
The US Open, yep. Well done.
Yeah,
Yeah.
Okay, Jim, home question or away?
I've been instructed to go away.
Okay, how's your golf?
Not so good.
Oh, dear. Other than Tiger Woods, three Americans have won the Open, the British Open, since 2000. Name two of them.
Okay.
Since 2000. Other than Tiger Woods, three of them.
That's Leonard and Daly, right?
No. No. Since when?
Since 2000.
Since 2000.
Is it Todd Hamilton?
Yeah, Todd Hamilton.
And Justin Leonard. When did Duval win it? No, he was...
Oh, that might be him. I think it's him, but we can't take a chance because we'll get the other one.
What was the guy who was the rookie that won it?
Oh, okay, I know. Because Thomas Bjorn was in the bunker. It took about 4 to come out.
Ben somebody or other.
That's it, Ben Curtis. Well done, Ben Curtis.
Ben Curtis and Todd Hamilton. Yeah, is that right? Yeah. You sure of those?
Yes.
No. Positive?
No.
Will you back me?
Yes, 100%.
All right, Todd Hamilton and Ben Curtis.
You get the 2 points, yes, well done. And did you have the other one?
Was Duval the other one?
It was, yeah. David Duval, yes. For the captains only this week, you'll each see a famous sports person transform into somebody else. The quicker you can identify who the second person is, the more points you will be awarded. Matt, here's your first one, and remember, only you can buzz in. No help from your team. So who is David Beckham transforming into? And?
Ronnie O'Sullivan.
It is, yes. Well done. 2 points. Over to you, Ali. Remember, you're on your own. Who is Kelly Southerton turning into?
Paula Radcliffe. Gail Emms. Bobby Charlton. And my last throw of dice is Frank Bruno.
We'll run it out, but I think Jim knows. We've already mentioned her in the show, Maria Sharapova. Yeah. Over to you, Matt. Who is Frankie turning into?
Fernando Alonso.
It is, yes. Well done. 2 points. And finally, Ali, who is Carlos Valderrama turning into?
Oh, just keep coming. Kevin Peterson.
Yes, well done, 2 points. So, end of that round, Ali's on 15, Matt on 23. Matt, who's this?
Do you get to answer that? The guy with the guitar? Mm-hmm.
Clearly not a lot of rhythm.
Oh, it is as well, isn't it?
Yeah, you having it?
I'm having it. I haven't got a dinner, but how old is
it? It would have to be someone like him to do that.
Well, that is his own gear as well. We're going to go for
that. Yeah, I love that.
Peter Reed.
Let's see. Former England international. Well done. Ali, who's this enjoying a French wine tasting lesson?
So first thing we are going to look at is the color. Okay, is it a strong color? Is it a dark color? Or is it a light color? Okay, if it's light, that means the wine is not very concentrated, so it will be light in taste as well. Okay, next step, taking a look at viscosity. So what you do here, you swirl your wine like this. You'll notice that some things are going to go down, and those things dripping down are called legs, also called tears, okay, like a tear going down your face. And this will highlight either the sugar or the alcohol in your wine. So lots of tears means lots of sugar, okay, so sweet wine are strong, powerful, lots of alcohol. We're ready to move on to the second step, smell your wine. Very simple, you just put your nose inside your glass and inhale deeply. So this, in France, is called the premier nez, first nose in English, okay? So cheer.
What, do you recognize the nose hairs or what?
Edwin got it straight away.
Tim Henman.
Let's have a look.
Cheers.
British tennis star Tim Henman, well done. Yeah. So full marks to both teams in that round. So Ali's now on 17, but Matt on 25. The buzz around this week is a question of venues. I will give you the name of a sporting event and the year in which it took place. You have to tell me if it took place in the United States, in England, or neither. Just buzz in and say USA, England, or neither. Ready? Here we go. 1996 Summer Olympics. Ali. USA, England, or neither?
96. Atlanta. Neither.
USA, England, or neither?
Atlanta. USA.
Thank you. 2003 Davis Cup final. It was neither. Melbourne, Australia. 91 Rugby World Cup final. Ali.
UK. Great Britain.
England will do. Twickenham. 1997 Ryder Cup. Ali.
USA.
No, it was neither. It was Valderrama in Spain. The 94 Football World Cup. Ali. 94.
USA.
Yes. 2001 World Athletics Championships.
2001 World Athletics Championships would have been in...
USA, England, or neither?
Neither.
Neither is right. It was Edmonton, Canada. 2002 Winter Olympics. Ali.
Ave Moore.
Salt Lake City, USA, we were looking for. The 19. The end. Ali finishes on 19, but Matt's team, they're the winners with 25. A big thank you to our guests, to Justin, to Jamie, to Jim and Edwin. The three of us will see you in 2006. Have a happy new year from all of us here. Bye-bye.
More from the team next Friday at 7. Lots of football tomorrow, goals and results as they happen in Final Score. Have your say in 6.06 on 5 Live and see highlights in Match of the Day at 10.30 here on BBC One. Next tonight, a most mysterious murder.